Hey, hey! Here we are again with another episode of ISL Online TV. This time around, we'll go into the installation process of ISL Conference Proxy, an essential installation needed to host ISL Online sessions directly from your own server. Alright, so first, I'm going to need to log into my account. Now see here, this is where all the hosted options are. In order to get to the server license area, I click on my account on the top right corner and select server license. The next thing I'm going to do is already start defining my server. So I click on the little orange button here that says add server. You'll then be prompted to enter the necessary server info. Now on a side note, you should really consider using a DNS address and making sure that the DNS address resolves to the server you want to define. This maintains all the always-on computers in case an IP changes. The next step, if you're not using a trial and have purchased a server license already, is to assign said licenses to the newly created server by clicking Assign, Edit, and selecting the server address in the dropdown. Skip this step if you're using a trial. Okay, so once that's out of the way, go ahead and create your packet. This essentially incorporates all the info regarding your ISLonline.com account, along with the server definition we just went through now. Out of this packet, you're then able to create your very first license file, which can be found right here. Now let's click on that license file in order to download to my computer, and when that's done, go straight to the green button that says README. This will direct you to the installation guide, where you'll be able to find some specific information along with the ISL Conference Proxy installer. Now personally, I'm running Windows, so I'm going to go ahead and click Windows 64-bit. However, there's enough info in this guide to help you figure out what small different steps you may need to take in order to install it on another operating system, such as Linux and the 32-bit versions. Alright, so, once you've gone through the installation wizard, you'll find the ISL Conference Proxy Login Admin menu waiting for you in your browser. By default, the login is admin and the password is ASD. Okay, so remember that little license file we just downloaded? This one right here? Go ahead and attribute it to your server by going under Manage Software, Licenses. You'll see a little field where you can upload it. Okay, so now that the license is properly in sync with your ISL Conference Proxy, there are two more steps for you regarding the installation process. First, you'll need to simply go down to Online Update. This is where all of the ISL software is going to be downloaded to your server, and this may take a minute or two. Once you've done that, you'll have to restart ISL Conference Proxy for the changes to take effect. You'll notice there's already a notification right here telling you to do so. Now, don't be alarmed at the beginning when you see the server status set to unavailable in red letters. You'll notice in a few seconds or so, it'll change back to checking and back to unavailable again. Now here's a nice time to grab a nice quick coffee break while you wait. All right, we're back. Conference Proxy fully installed. Now the last thing to do here is to create at least one user. You see, the admin login we used right now is for the configuration page only. It's your created user that you'll be establishing remote desktop sessions with. Now this is easily found in the User Management section of ISL Conference Proxy. The domain that will host your username is default, but you can change that or even create a new domain later on. Anyway, go ahead and create a new user by filling out the credentials. Once this is done, go ahead and enter the DNS name you established earlier on. And here we go, your very own server license page, where you'll be managing all of your computers, as well as direct your clients to enter a session code. This is fully customizable, by the way, and we'll cover that shortly. Well, I hope you found this useful, and as always, click that live chat button if you need anything else clarified. Until next time.